Hello once again, our most valued student. My name is Confident and welcome to our 24-minute lesson. This is the ultimate guide in maths, science, career guidance, as well as a sneak peek into my personal experiences. This is a channel designed with you in mind. Let us dive into today's lesson. In this video, we are still continuing with the ultimate guide in our mathematics for grade 11, and we already been looking at here exponents and sets, and these are the questions that you guys will be doing in your term one, and I'm going to be giving you some brief work on what you guys need to expect for your grade 11. And we did look at already some question here. We have done two videos which looked at this question 1.1, and 1.2 is the one that we did all here. So you guys, if you're not subscribed, that's why you're missing out on a lot of lessons. So I'll encourage you just to subscribe. Then 1.3, I did it here. Now let us look at this one. It says examples continued. Simplify without a calculator the following expressions fully, and I asked you to do for me 2.1, and I said let's compare our answers. If you have done it, what did you get? Now 2.1 is 3 marks. It mustn't in a way become difficult. Now the key word is express everything in terms of the same base. Look at this. What is the base? You've got 2. If I make this bigger, what is the base here? It's 4 and 8. You can still express 4, remember is 2 squared, and then 8 is 2 to the power of 3. That's the main part. But when you're going to express this, look where you need to be very sensitive. The 2 to the power of n plus 2 is not a problem, times, but look now, if you're going to make 4 in terms of base 2, you're going to say 2 squared, but now don't also forget you need the bracket so that that n plus 1 is like that. But if you do it like this, it looks mathematically wrong, because it's as if it's 2 times n, it's like it is 2 times n plus 1. And if you apply both mass, you will have now 2n plus 1. Then this becomes now wrong. So the best way to do, so that you don't get this the wrong way, so what you can do, you can put the bracket, yes, like this. You can put the bracket like this, but also put that bracket to say n plus 1, so that the whole bracket is showing that the 2 is affecting n plus 1. That's the key thing there. Are you with me? I'll show you the simpler way you could have written this. All right, so look at the next one. All over, I think you can guess, 8 is 2 to the power of 3. Now the best way you could have done it on top, instead of putting this bracket and then putting that n minus 1, what you can do, you can just simple do it like this. You just say bracket n minus 1. It just simplifies lots of things. Do you see that? So that is the easier way. Then equal to, and then what you have is 2 to the power of n plus 2 dot, open that bracket. Remember, you are saying 2 times n, 2 times 2, which is 2 to the exponent of 2n plus 2 over, do the same thing, 3 times that and 3 times that, over 2 to the exponent of 3n minus 3. Now from here, different approaches you could have done, but I will always encourage this to the students. Let me take it here. This is what I encourage you, because errors are always common. Remember I told you that this law, a to the power of m plus n is equal to a to the power of a to the power of n. I said the common way of writing this law, the first law, it says a to the power of m times a to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. So now I said if I write it backwards, then I get this one, where a to the power of m plus n is now on the other side, and then you get times here is on the other side. You see that? So this law, a, let me write again, to the power of m plus n Since I'm adding here, I'll write the a to the power of m times a to the power of m. I will encourage them to use this version whereby that part becomes 2 to the power of, like this, 2 to the power of n times 2 to the power of 2 times 2 to the power of 2n times 2 to the power of 2 over 2 to the power of 3n times 2 to the power of minus 3. I'll tell you why I prefer this way. Then from here, we can then simplify. Remember, when I want to simplify this, whatever goes to the top, it changes signs. So I'm going to collect like terms. This is common, that is common. It's 2 to the power of n, remember, it's same base, times 2 to the power of 2n, and then times, when this goes to the top, it becomes 2 to the power minus 3n. I could have done that. And then times, that one I'm done, and this one is 2 to the power of 2 times, and that one is 2 to the power of 2 times. This one goes to the top, it's negative, now it becomes 2 to the power. Negative becomes positive. Alright. You could have avoided this step. You could have avoided and gone from here. You could have just said, since it's already a multiplication and division, you use the law to say this is same as 2 to the power of n plus 2n minus 3n. The division, remember, going to the top, and then times 2 to the power of 2 plus 2. Since this was below, going to the top, it was going to be plus 3. Alright, and then equal to, then you finalize to say, what is n plus 2n is 3n, so you've got 2 to the power of 3n minus 3n times 2 to the power 2 plus 2, 4 plus 3 is 7, which is equal to 2 to the power of 0 times 2 to the power of 7. And then what is 2 to the power of 0? It's what? It's 1 times 2 to the power of 7. You can leave your answer like that. It's still correct because they say don't use a calculator, so it's fine to leave your answer like that. If you still want, you can continue to say 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times, how many times? 7 times 2 times 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's just 2 times 2, 4. 4 times 2, 8. 8 times 2, 16. 16 times 2, 32. 32 times 2, 64. 64 times 2, which is 128. You can still do this. It's still allowed, but you can test that with the calculator, of course. Alright, but this last step is up to you. Then there is someone who could have said, but why didn't you do something simpler here? And then they wanted me to apply the law here. It's fine, you can apply the law. Look at this. You're going to say 2 to the power of n plus 2. Already, I'm adding that plus that plus 2n plus 2. Since I'm dividing, this becomes minus, and then it's 3n minus 3. See, now can you pick up the error here? There is minus. Where is the error? That's where most of you were going to get this wrong. So they're going to add this plus this. I hope you're picking up the error. And this, what is n plus 2n, 3n minus that, which is 2 to the power of this, I mean n plus 2n is 3n minus 3n, it's 0. And then the numbers, 2 plus 2, it's 4, 4 minus 3, which is 2 to the power of 1. My question is, do you see where I made the error? If you are not seeing, this is where the error is. When you say it minus, when you're taking this to the top, because it's one thing, you're supposed to put a what? A bracket there. So this minus will affect that, and then the minus minus, it becomes a plus. Hence, you'll have 2 plus 2 plus 3. Then it gives you 2 to the power of 7. I'm avoiding that error so that by splitting it, it's not easy to miss it now, because you can see that this needs to go to the top, and then it changes everything. All right. So that was that. Let's look at this other example here. 2.2 says you're supposed to simplify this. Square root of that. So if I can change this all together, you see it will become That square root is same as what? That square root is same as bracket here to the power half, and then dot again bracket here to the power half. Are you seeing that? Then I will have x plus again this square root in this the inner square root there. Again is bracket to the power half, and here bracket to the power half. So what do I have? I've got 2x minus 1. I've got 2x minus 1, but I've got x minus, I've x plus. If you recall, the x plus and x minus is more like a difference of two squares. You can maybe simplify this and say let here, you can say let 2x minus 1, this one be equal to k. So what you'll have here, you'll have equal to bracket x plus k to the power half. Are you seeing that? Bracket half, and then you've got x minus k, because this is now k and that is k, so it's k to the power half. X minus k to the power half, bracket 1 over 2. That's what you'll be having now. If you want, then you can now look at this. If I give you square root of 4, right, times square root of 8, you are allowed to say square root of 4 times 8 under the same square root. Meaning, if I say 4 to the power half times 8 to the power half, you are allowed to say 4 times 8, because they are in the same power, bracket to the power half. Are you seeing what I'm trying to do there? So even here, since I'm given this part, look at this, power half, power half, I'm allowed to, and I'm multiplying there, so I'm allowed to take what and say equal to x plus k to the power half, and then x minus k to the power half, and put everything to the power 1 over 2. Look at the big bracket. Now I can then expand this and say x times this and this times this. Look what I'm multiplying. If you still remember the difference of two squares, if I give you, for example, if I say m minus n and m plus n, when I'm multiplying m times n and m times like that, and then this times this and this times this, when you expand this, you left m times m is m squared, m times n plus mn, minus m times n minus mn, and then what? And then minus n times that is becomes minus n squared. But look, because it's a difference of two squares, m minus n, m plus n, you will see that the center mn minus mn, it becomes zero. So you are left with m squared minus n squared. You just multiply the first, I can say m minus n, again m plus n. So it's as good as multiplying the first and the last, which is m squared minus n squared. See that? So the same thing here, you just multiply the first, x times x is becoming what? X squared, and then last one, k to the power half times k to the power negative k to the power half times k to the power half. See that? Bracket, but don't forget this outside bracket is half, which is equal to, we continue with the bigger bracket that is left outside. Now same base, it's minus k, half plus half, remember I'm adding there, and half plus half is simple 1, so it's simple k to the power 1 to the power half. Are you seeing that? That's it. Which is equal to, and then I still have x squared, but remember what we said our k is. I said let k be equal to 2x minus 1, you see. So I'm gonna bring in back that 2x minus 1, which is minus bracket, don't forget the bracket, 2x minus 1, and then to the power half. Are you seeing that? Don't forget that. Which is equal to You still continue x squared. Open now. Open now the bracket. The negative affect that, which is minus 2x. The negative affect that, minus minus, it's plus 1 to the power half, which is equal to. And then if you know how to factorize this, the inside, if you factorize the inside, this is same as x minus 1, x minus 1. If I multiply this, it's x squared, that times that, minus x, this time this, minus x, this time that, it's plus 1, which is x squared minus 2x plus 1, which is that inside it. So what do? You know that this becomes x minus 1 and x minus 1, everything to the power 1 over 2. But what is x minus 1? X minus 1 is same as x minus 1 squared multiplied by 1 over 2, which is equal to, then this will multiply 2 times half, it's 1, which is the simple x minus 1. So the answer simply becomes what? X minus 1. So that is how you can do that. You can try to prove it yourself. What you do is you say let, choose any value. Here say let x be equal to, let's say, let me choose 15 again. So what you do is you take your calculator. Since x is 15, you come here, square root of 15 plus, say it 15 plus square root of 2 times 15 minus 1. Are you getting that? You play forward and then you say times again square root of 15 minus square root of 2 times 15 minus 1 equal to, you see I got 14 in here. The answer was 14. You do the same thing on the, we got 14 here as the answer. You do the same thing here. If x is 15 here, so it will be 15 minus 1, which is 14. It means my value for x minus 1 is correct. You don't have to say the answer is 14. I say let. It's an assumption. So this you wrap off, because that's not the actual answer. The actual answer is x minus 1. So guys, that's how you simplify. Let's join me in the next lesson as I keep on doing some more activities on exponents. But more important now, we are going to have to start looking at something else, which is this part, sets. So the next part is to now focus on sets. In a way, these were sets, these ones. This question, it was already on sets, because sets means square root. Okay, so even this question also was on sets. These are sets already. You understand? These are what you mean by saying sets. But anyway, we'll look some more questions of that, which means the more part that you now must expect is the equations and inequalities, a very important aspect that you need to know. We've come to the end of our lesson. Thank you.